नमस्कार, मेरा नाम मार्कंडे राय है। हम यहीं भारत के ही रहने वाले हैं। बहुत दिनों तक विदेश में काम करते रहे। पहले तो प्रोफेसर थे, पीछे किसी पढ़ाते थे, बहुत विभिन्न देशों में घूम करके हमने पढ़ाया। उसके बाद 25 साल से हम संयुक्त राष्ट्र संघ की सेवा में रहे हैं। संयुक्त राष्ट्र संघ की एक शाखा है जो कि यूनाइटेड नेशन ह्यूमन सेटलमेंट प्रोग्राम कहते हैं, ग्रीफ में उसको यूएन हैबिटेट कहते हैं। उसी यूएन हैबिटेट में विभिन्न पदों पर काम करते रहे और पिछले साल रिटायर किए, तो यूएन हैबिटेट ने हमको प्रमुख सलाहकार, स्पेशल एडवाइजर या सीनियर एडवाइजर के पद पर नियुक्त कर दिया है। उसके साथ कुछ और भी काम करते हैं, युवा सत्ता से भी जुड़े हुए हैं। हम पीस एम्बेसडर हैं ग्लोबल पीस फाउंडेशन के, और भारत सरकार ने भी हमको एक पद दिया है क्वालिटी काउंसिल ऑफ इंडिया में, एक बोर्ड के हम चेयरमैन हैं। और कुछ इंस्टीट्यूट और कुछ सोशल संस्थाओं में काम करते रहते हैं। यहाँ आकर के बड़ा अच्छा लगा हमको कि युवा सत्ता के साथ कई सालों से जुड़े हुए हैं और युवा सत्ता इज डूइंग अ ग्रेट वर्क। आज के युग में जब जस्ट एक दिन पहले विश्व ने 2015 पोस्ट डेवलपमेंट एजेंडा या जिसको सस्टेनेबल डेवलपमेंट गोल्स कहते हैं, उसको मेजॉरिटी वोट से और कई देशों के प्रमुख के नेतृत्व में अभी संयुक्त राष्ट्र संघ ने अडॉप्ट किया है, उसमें सार्क कंट्री की और स्पेशली यूथ की बहुत अहम भूमिका होगी। आज सार्क कंट्री में यूथ की काफ़ी बड़ी संख्या है। तो भारत में ही अगर लें तो मीडियन एज अभी 27 साल है। अब 450 मिलियन यूथ भारत में है। विभिन्न सार्क कंट्री देशों में 8 जो कंट्री जो मेंबर हैं उनमें यूथ की संख्या, उनका पॉपुलेशन काफ़ी बड़ा है। और इस साल का जो 21 सितंबर को जो पीस डे था, उसमें यूएन का मैसेज यही था कि सिविल सोसाइटी बहुत बड़ा इंपॉर्टेंट रोल अदा कर सकते हैं। अब बिना यूथ के, यूथ इज एनर्जी, यूथ इज पावर, यूथ इज द लीडर ऑफ टुडे एंड टुमारो। बिना उनके सपोर्ट के, बिना उनके सहयोग के सार्क कंट्री की जितनी भी समस्याएं हैं उनको हल करके इनको आगे विकसित नहीं किया सकता। भारत ने युवा शक्ति को पहचाना है। 2014 में यूथ की पॉलिसी भारत सरकार ने बनाया है, यूथ एडवाइजरी कमेटी भी बनाया है, और आज भारत को महसूस हुआ है और पहले से भी ज़्यादा महसूस हुआ है इस खास तौर से अभी वर्तमान सरकार में, कि बिना यूथ के इन्वॉल्व के आज भारत विकसित देश नहीं बन सकता है। यूथ की संख्या बहुत बड़ी संख्या है यहाँ पर। आज भारत कम से कम 25 साल तक आने वाले भविष्य में एक युवा शक्ति के रूप में ही जाना जाएगा। आज युवा शक्ति की कोई प्रयोग न किया जाए एक बहुत बड़ा नुकसान है। और भारत ने एक यूथ की मिनिस्ट्री भी बना दी है और यूथ के लिए हर जगह फंड और कार्यक्रम चलाया जा रहा है, जिसमें एक बहुत इम्पॉर्टेंट कार्यक्रम है नेशनल स्किल डेवलपमेंट प्रोग्राम, जहाँ की कैसे रोजगार यूथ को मिल सकता है, कैसे उनको मीनिंगफुल वे से इन्वॉल्व कर सकता है, कैसे भारत में मोर देन 100 सिटीज को स्मार्ट सिटी बना सकता है, स्वच्छ भारत बना सकता है। इन्हें हर जगह भूमिका यूथ की, युवा शक्ति की बहुत इम्पॉर्टेंट है। यूथ की भूमिका बहुत बड़ी अहम है। अगर सार्क कंट्री विकास करना चाहते हैं और जितने भी चैलेंजेज और जितनी प्रॉब्लम्स हैं उनको टैकल करना चाहते हैं, बहुत बड़ा अपॉर्चुनिटी है भी है और बहुत बड़ा चैलेंज भी है। जब हमने अभी 2 दिन पहले पोस्ट डेवलपमेंट एजेंडा को अडॉप्ट किया, उसमें यूथ की भूमिका नंबर 1 गोल से लेकर के 17वें गोल तक, हर गोल में यूथ की बहुत अहम भूमिका होगी। हमको लगता है, हमारा मानना है कि जब भी सार्क की समिट हो रही है और हर साल एक बार मिनिस्ट्रियल लेवल की समिट होती है और 2 बार उसके की सेक्रेटरी लेवल की, उसमें यूथ का एजेंडा जरूर डिस्कस होना चाहिए और उस समिट में यूथ को इन्वॉल्व भी करना चाहिए, ताकि मैंने जब भी बात आए तो यूथ महसूस करे कि जो भी एजेंडा बन रहा है उसमें उनकी सहभागिता है, उनका पार्टिसिपेशन है, उनका सपोर्ट है, उनका एक्टिव रोल बना हुआ है। और ऐसे में यूथ रेडी है, तैयार है यहाँ का उसमें सपोर्ट करने के लिए। चैलेंज और अपॉर्चुनिटी दोनों एक ही सिक्के के 2 पहलू हैं। जहाँ यूथ के सामने चैलेंज है वहीं अपॉर्चुनिटीज भी हैं। चैलेंज ये है कि कैसे इनको यूथ को, युवा शक्ति को फ्रॉम द बिगिनिंग उनको इन्वॉल्व किया जाए प्रगति में, डेवलपमेंट, ओवरऑल डेवलपमेंट में। चैलेंज ये है कि एम्प्लॉयमेंट कैसे क्रिएट किया जाए और उनको सुटेबल एम्प्लॉयमेंट, उनके क्वालिफिकेशन के अनुसार एम्प्लॉयमेंट कैसे मिले। सबसे बड़ा फ्रस्ट्रेशन आज यूथ का है, चाहे पूरा विश्व में देखें या सार कंट्री में वही लागू होता है, भारत से लेकर के सार के डिफरेंट कंट्री में भी अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट, बेरोजगार की जो सबसे बड़ी समस्या है यूथ के सामने। दूसरा एक यूथ को उनके मन चाहे काम का न मिलना, और तीसरा अंडर पेमेंट, कम से कम पेमेंट की। बहुत से यूथ को जॉब तो मिल जा रहा है लेकिन पेमेंट इतना कम है कि उससे उनका काम नहीं चल पाता है, दे फील फ्रस्ट्रेटेड। तो सबसे बड़ी बात है कि इनइक्वालिटी बहुत बढ़ती जा रही है सोसाइटी में। जो आज माइग्रेशन हो रहा है रूरल से अर्बन एरिया में, जैसे कि आप देखें चंडीगढ़ से लेकर के दिल्ली तक में हर जगह माइग्रेशन से पॉपुलेशन बढ़ रही है, वो अपने बेटर अपॉर्चुनिटी के लिए आते हैं लेकिन वो एंड करते हैं किसी न किसी स्लम एरिया में या कोई गलत काम में, या न रोजगार मिलने से उनका सबसे बड़ा बड़ा दुख है और सबसे बड़ा उनका चैलेंज भी है कि कैसे यूथ को मीनिंगफुल वे से इंगेज किया जाए सोसाइटी और देश के निर्माण में और विश्व के निर्माण में। अगर मुझे एक लाइन में अपना मैसेज यूथ को देना है, मैं ये कहूँगा कि 21st सेंचुरी इज द सेंचुरी ऑफ एक्शन एंड यू आर द वन हु हैज टू टेक द लीड। यू आर नॉट द लीडर ऑफ टुमारो, यू आर द लीडर ऑफ टुडे एंड टुमारो एज वेल। टू टेक दिस स्टेप्स विदाउट योर सपोर्ट, विदाउट योर एक्टिव पार्टिसिपेशन, दिस एनी गोल और एनी अचीवमेंट कांट बी मेड। एंड विश्व एक अच्छा विश्व नहीं बन सकता है, एक समृद्ध विश्व नहीं बन सकता है बिना यूथ के पार्टिसिपेशन के। ये प्रूव हो चुका है अरब स्प्रिंग से, या आज जितने भी स्पेन, ग्रीस और आइसलैंड जो सिचुएशन है, जहाँ भी यूथ खुश नहीं है वहाँ न शांति हो सकती है न प्रगति हो सकती है। इसलिए यूथ को हम कहते हैं किसी के लिए इंतजार मत करो, टेक द कंट्रोल, टेक द लीडरशिप, मूव ऑन। मुझे अपने निर्णय पर भारत लौटने का जो मैंने निर्णय लिया उस पर मुझे गर्व है, मुझे लगता है कि मैंने बहुत उचित और सही निर्णय लिया। प्रवास के 28 सालों में जो मैं विदेशों में बिताया, जिसमें यूनाइटेड नेशन में बहुत बड़ा समय निकाला हमने क्वार्टर सेंचुरी का, उसके बाद हमको लगता था कि अपने एक्सपीरियंस और अपने अनुभवों के आधार पर हमको अपने मातृभूमि की सेवा करनी चाहिए, और मैं मातृभूमि की सेवा करने के लिए आया, ये मुझे बड़ा गर्व होता है। और मुझे अपने निर्णय पर अभी भी कोई संकोच नहीं है, रेदर हमको बड़ा गर्व है कि मैं ये निर्णय लिया कि हमको प्रदेश लौट जाना चाहिए और कुछ भी जो भी हम कर सकें अपने लेवल से वो सेवा करनी चाहिए। उस सेवा में युवा सत्ता में ज्वाइन करना, आना यहाँ, कंट्रीब्यूट करना, यूथ के भावनाओं को समझना और यूथ के मैसेज को सुनना और देखना कि कैसे इसको कोऑर्डिनेट किया सकता है एज एडवाइजर टू युवा सत्ता, कैसे हम क्या रोल कर सकते हैं कि यूथ को एक साथ ले जा सकें और उनको नेशनल ही नहीं, रीजनल, ग्लोबल बिल्डिंग में और डेवलपमेंट में उनको लगा सकें। आज ये मुझे बहुत ही गर्व है कि 30 कंट्री के यूथ युवा सत्ता के 10वें वार्षिक उत्सव में आए हुए हैं और वो अपना अपना अनुभव, अपनी अपनी एक विश्व का जो वसुधैव कुटुंबकम की जो हम लोगों की फिलॉसफी है, जिसको कि युवा सत्ता ने भी अडॉप्ट किया है, वसुधैव कुटुंबकम की, अहिंसा की, पीस की, एक ही विश्व का सचमुच अगर हम लोग चाहते हैं कि एक परिवार बन जाए, ये बहुत बड़ा अहम भूमिका निभाएगा युवा सत्ता का एनुअल फंक्शन। हमको इसको बढ़ाना है ताकि एक आने वाले समय में पूरे विश्व के देश इसमें ज्वाइन कर सकें, एक साथ बैठ करके अपनी समस्याओं पर चर्चा कर सकें और उसके सलूशन के समाधान भी निकालें कि कैसे विश्व को एक और भी समृद्ध, उन्नतशील, पीसफुल और प्रगतिशील विश्व बनाया जा सके।
My name is Bernie Meyer. I'm from the United States of America and grew up in America and grew up in the Middle West of the United States. At a time there was a lot of problems and social conflict. It was the 1960s when I became a man and a Catholic priest in 1965 in Cleveland. It was a time that the civil rights movement was coming forward with the leadership of people like Martin Luther King Jr. And there were riots all over the big cities of the United States, including Cleveland. It was also a time of the Vietnam War, when the United States was bombing Vietnam, fighting a war there. And I saw these things as wrong. It took me time to discover that. But I saw them as wrong, and I thought, this is a moral situation. When you do something wrong like killing in war, it has moral implications, moral meaning. And so at that time, I got involved during those years, 1965, 66, 67, 68, and got special training for it. So I started acting, and I learned about civil disobedience. We call them direct actions, where we risk arrest, risk prison, to make a point about moral questions. And Gandhi was one of the persons, his writings, his ideology, his belief in truth, his belief in love. This moved me and moved some of my friends to challenge the U.S. government stop the war in Vietnam, to challenge the Dow Chemical Company to stop the war in Vietnam and stop making money on it. And so we did a civil disobedience in Washington, D.C. in 1969. We went into the Dow Chemical offices, hung up pictures of people in Vietnam who were napalm, especially children, and poured blood on the floor and walls, and smashed up office equipment. Then we waited for the police to arrive, and the police arrested us, and then I went to prison. So this period of time started me on this path of which Gandhi was a big inspiration. And that's been my life since then. I got married, had three children, raised those children, and then started getting more active again about nuclear weapons and about war and about other social problems. Racism is a big one in the United States. Poverty is a big one. And so I've been doing things about that ever since. That's my background in a way. I now live in Olympia, Washington, where the Trident submarine is, and that's one of the most powerful weapons the United States has. And the base has over 2,000 nuclear weapons. And if that area was a nation, it would be the third most powerful nation in the world because of the destruction by nuclear weapons. So for 38 years, I've been working with the Ground Zero community for nonviolent action, saying we must abolish nuclear weapons. So that's my background. In terms of my engagement here with SAARC, Southeast Asia youth efforts, I've been coming to India to educate youth as Gandhi. This started in 2002 and started in 2005, coming to India by invitation. By invitation. And Dr. Siobhan invited me from Aurangabad, and the reason he invited me was he wanted to educate youth about Gandhi's way. So I think Gandhi's principles still mean a lot, still guide us to live by truth, satyagraha, truth force, love force, soul force. That's key for Gandhi. And then ahimsa, nonviolence, or better, love. unwilling to do harm to another. So these two basic principles of Gandhi guide me in what I do, and I think they should guide SAARC in what it does. It wants to help youth in India, well, teach morality, teach truth, teach love, and develop ways of life that are consistent with Satya, with Ahimsa. And so I'm here to encourage that. In terms of my own country, youth involvement is very diverse. Because it's a complicated country, with a wealthy country, you have many different institutions, many different approaches, and so on. So youth activity varies, but the same principles can be applied in the United States as here or anywhere. And so we have activist youth groups, and we have a lot of youth that are ignorant, that need education about what's going on. Right now, one of the major efforts that came up this last two summers was the black youth, the black young people who are being killed by police. The police we have overreact to black youth on the streets, especially poor black youth, but any income level. If they think that they should suspect you of something, that at times they'll kill you literally by shooting you or choking you to death, and this is happening all the time. So the black youth are saying black lives matter, and this kind of a pose represents some of the black youth that we're trying to say to the police, we're not attacking you, we're not here to hurt you, and the police shoot them anyway. So black lives matter, black lives matter. That's on the streets. We have a lot of poor black people living in areas like Baltimore, Maryland, and Detroit, Michigan, and so on. So there's a real understanding gap between a lot of the police and the youth living in those poor areas. So that's one type of movement in the United States, but there are other types too. Climate is a big issue today. More and more people are worried about what we're doing or not doing. We should be getting rid of coal and oil and gas. We should not be burning it, sending CO2 in the atmosphere. So a lot of youth, and I joined them, I take part in these, to say no to coal. Don't ship coal to Asia, okay? Don't use oil and gas. Shell oil company going to the Arctic to explore for oil. We try to block the ships that are going to the Arctic to explore, because if we burn the oil that can be brought up, it means the end of the human race this century, and the effects are starting already. The climate change with only 1 degree centigrade raise has led to many forest fires, to acidification of the oceans, to loss of water, and war, even contribute to wars. Like in Syria, there was a big drought, and climate contributed to that drought, made it worse, and the farmers could not make a living, so they joined the revolutions there against the government, because they could not make a living, the farmers did that. So there's a lot of different things to think about here and to react to. And to youth, create simple ways of living, wherever you live and study Gandhi's idea of the villages and living simply. Stop using gas and oil and create ways of growing food and ways of doing transportation that does not send this stuff into the atmosphere. And join together with all these other movements to say to the governments in the UN to come up with a way of ending the climate crisis, stopping the damage from going any farther. We can't stop it all because it's already happening, but we can limit it. But we only have a couple of years to do that, literally, only a couple of years. And it's youth that's be most affected. If the temperature rises 4 to 6 degrees centigrade this century, youth and their kids and grandkids will all be affected, and maybe all life will end. There's a lot more to say about this, and my encouragement is for all youth groups to become more aware, to study the economy, to study energy, to study the climate, study what's going on, and then try to make ways of life that are good for human living, that's good for all the beautiful birds we hear singing here, and all the animals.
Assalamu alaikum. I'm Murtaza Rahimi, and I'm from Afghanistan. I'm working for Afghans for Progressive Thinking. I'm graduated from Law and Political Science Faculty. Right now, I'm with the Afghans for Progressive Thinking. We are working with the university students to promote a culture of openness, respect, and tolerance among the youth people, the youth. It is really important for the youth to be engaged in the civic activities in far countries, because in far countries there are lots of problems right now that the people are facing. And if the youth get engaged in those and the civic, if they have a civic engagement, then they can work toward these problems, and they can find out the problems, and they can work together, create networks, and they can actually find solutions for all these problems. And if they, because youth are the future leaders of all these countries, if they work from now on, then they can have a better plan and have a better solution for all these problems. And it is really important for them to be engaged in all civic activities in SAARC countries. After the fall of the Taliban regime in Afghanistan, now the youth are participating in different activities inside the country. Even now they go outside the Afghanistan and they participate in different programs in other countries. It's because now they have opportunities and there are other countries helping the Afghan youth to participate in the same activities. And also, for example, Afghans for Progressive is an organization that we have different programs for the youth to participate. Like we have debate programs where the Afghan youth from the different universities can come together and they can debate on different issues inside Afghanistan and outside, and they can. That's the kind of way that they can find solution for all the problems inside Afghanistan. But unfortunately, during the security problems in Afghanistan, it is kind of impossible for other youth to participate in the civic activities inside Afghanistan. Although there are organizations that the youth from other countries work for those organizations and help the Afghan youth, but we don't have a kind of forum or program in which other youth can come inside Afghanistan and they can better understand the Afghans inside Afghanistan by participating in those forums. The young people in far countries have an important role in strengthening the good relationship about the SAARC member countries, because for example in the GYPF when I participated here, I saw the young people from different countries that they have a better mind and they don't have hate for each other and they are treating everyone in a better way. And if these people get together and if the young people work together, they can create a better relationship among these four countries. And also the young people are the future leaders of each country. And if they work together and if they accept each other and if they are willing to create a better relationship among the four countries, then they are really good at it and they can be very meaningful for that. Today there are lots of problems for the youth that are stopping youth to progress. One of the biggest problems is the security problems. Right now in most countries, for example in Afghanistan and Pakistan, in countries in Arabic countries like Iraq, Syria, or some countries in Africa, they're facing really bad security problems, and these security problems take the opportunities from the youth. That's why they can't think of a better future. But there is still lots of opportunities for the youth. The youth can participate in the forums and other programs in the safe countries. In those countries, they can get new ideas, ideas that they can better their own country, and they can create a peaceful country. Because the biggest problem, I think, in the countries that they are not developing is because the people are not together with each other, and they are not united. And the youth can have this opportunity to change that and create a united nation in their own country. And then it will be able to solve this problem in there. My message for youth of 21st century is that they should be united, and they should create networks. And through networks, they can solve lots of problems that the world is facing right now in 21st century. Because all the youth are the futures of their own country and the future leaders of the world. So if they create networks, then that way they can share the problems that each country has. And by sharing the problems, they can find a better solution for lots of their problems. Because there are problems that are the same in most countries. If the youth from those countries create network and work together, then they can find a better solution by sharing their own idea from their life or from the experience that they have. So my message is that they should create network, and they should be united, and they should work through solving all the problems that each country is facing right now in the world. I have a really good experience of being in this summit and India. It's really different from Afghanistan, and the experience that I have in Afghanistan, the people are really nice, they are really kind, and it shows that if people be nice with each other, then it creates an art relation with each other. And I think this is really good, that all the people should have a good relationship and to be nice with each other. Because the feeling that I had when I first met one of the volunteers, and he was really nice to me, and it made me feel like that he's someone to me, or he has a relationship with me because of that. And I think this is really important for everyone to have this kind of relationship with each other. So that way we can create good relationship among each other, and I think this will stop the violence in all the countries. And it's really important. Thank you.
Hello, I'm Umar Shuja Qazi from Karachi, Pakistan, and I am a business graduate, and currently I'm doing my MBA and majors in finance from Shaheed Zulfikar Ali Bhutto Institute of Science and Technology from Karachi. And my prior experience is with British Council Pakistan, and I've been working on education campaign and revival of primary and secondary education in Pakistan. Civic engagements of youth in SAARC countries, it is very important topic basically. Youths from across the SAARC countries need to collaborate, come together, share ideas, share their views, share their viewpoints. Because basically we people from SAARC countries share similar culture, similar norms and values with a little bit of differences. So it's basically our problems and issues are quite similar to each other. So we need to understand our issues basically, and you know, we should respect the differences whatever they are, and come together, collaborate, and work on conflict resolutions, and you know, bring about the much needed requirements like peace. We should work on issues such as education, poverty, and other issues. About mechanisms of youth participation in my country, Pakistan. I'd like to describe it in a way that, you know, there is a complete setup of NGO network in Pakistan. There are like big NGOs working in Pakistan, like Save the Children, and there are some organizations such as British Council Pakistan and Oxfam Pakistan and others, several organizations that are basically working for civic engagements and, you know, working for human rights and other issues. So you know, on one hand there is this particular scope of area, but now the governments also, the state governments as well as the national government, are taking initiatives. There are several youth programs that have been launched in Pakistan. Youth development programs, skill development programs on national level that are there. And are working on yearly basis, on 5-yearly basis. So there's a lot to be done yet, but you know, the initiatives are working, and it's just a kickstart. It's just the start of a big scope of thing that we need to fill in. But yes, the things are moving towards the better prospects, and you know, it's working. It's working quite good in Pakistan. Talking about the challenges, there are several challenges if we count it. You know, there are lots of barriers between nations. Let's consider I'm from Pakistan and I'm here in India. So I know what I've gone through, like, you know, the procedures, the red tapism that basically there is in the bureaucracies of both the countries in India, Pakistan. So, you know, the visa policies are a big concern. People to people contacts are not so easy. Civic engagements in Pakistan, between Pakistan and India, are not so easy. Although the people are similar, the culture is similar. I mean, the love, affection that we get here in India is quite remarkable. But then again, you have to follow the procedures and the rules and regulations that are there in both sides of the border. So I think, you know, there should be a complete setup. Youth of Pakistan and youth of India or youth of other SAARC countries should collaborate and work on concrete policy making, and you know, there should be ice breaking on national levels and international levels to, you know, break down these barriers to make more and more people to people contacts and civic engagements that could lead to better future prospects and better opportunities for people across SAARC countries. My experiences in the Global Youth Peace Festival that is organized by Youth Sata in Chandigarh, and especially the second SAARC Youth Summit that is being held here specifically. My experiences have been remarkable. It's been really good. I feel really good to be here. I feel honored to be here. I was in the panel of. I was invited as a guest speaker in the panel of the second SAARC Youth Summit. So it's an honor to be here and represent my country, Pakistan, at a national level, at an international level, basically. So I feel really honored, and it's a dream come true for me to come to, you know, a state like India and, you know, represent my own country. People here are really good. The city, the culture, everything is quite similar to my own country. I really feel at home, and it's been an honor to be here, and I really want to come back again. I really want to be here again and represent my own country again. Thank you, India.
I'm Birendra Podel from Nepal, associated with Nepal Friendship Society, Clean Up Nepal, and other organization. I studied travel tourism from UK and rural development master's degree from Nepal. Civic engagement of youth in the SAARC countries, there are so many forums, so many different organizations, those are working in a SAARC level. So youth need to be engaged in different forums so that they need to more aware about the things what's happening in SAARC level. That is how we can empower the SAARC peoples, SAARC youth, so that the youth can be a unite, youth can do something for the, not only for their own country, but in SAARC level. My country, Nepal, youth are sometimes very confused what to do, what not to do. Regarding the mechanism of government of Nepal, we have different policy. For example, we have Youth National Policy 2011, we have Youth Vision 2025, so that there are so many ways youth can engage in according to government rule and regulation, government policy, youth can engage in different sector, different organization. As a government, they announce also different volunteering program for the youth so that they can directly participate and they can share their own experiences. That means all about sharing is caring. In 21st century, as a youth in SAARC level, we have so many challenges and opportunities. Actually, we have poverty, we have unemployment. So youth migration rate are very high in SAARC level. The skilled manpower are losing. And the youth always want to go to the developed country. They don't want to return the country. So the message we have, the youth for the 21st century need to engage in different emerging issues, for example, the climate change, different environmental issues, education sector, so that youth can lead not only the organization, youth can lead the country. Regarding my experiences in India, I'm very happy and delighted to be participating in this event, especially second SAARC Summit gave a lot of ideas, a lot of challenges and opportunities we discuss in SAARC level so that youth can aware more and more about the opportunity and strength in every country, even from local level, regional level and national level.